everyone. All right, well, it's a rainy day here in Martha's Vineyard for day 7 of my challenge to be trading on the traveling trading station. Goal, $1,000 a day. That's been the goal right along. And today has been, I suppose you could probably say, the worst, my worst trading performance of the 7 days I've been here. But it's not the smallest green day. And it is still a green day, which is good. So, well, you can see the P&L. So $1,500, $1,527.74. But I was up 7,000. And then I had 3 red trades in a row. I gave back $2,000 on AERC and went from up 7 to up 5. Then I gave back like $2,500 on RDBX and went from up 5 to up $2,700. And then I gave back $1,100 on MISC or MICS and went from up 27 approximately to 15. The problem is, as I was making my way up to 7,000, I generated commissions along the way to the tune of almost $800, $900. And so now as I sit here, having come back down to 1,500, well, I still have to take off that $1,000 in commissions. So I'm really only gonna be up about 500 bucks today after fees and commissions. Still better than Monday, where I was up only about 150 after fees and commissions. But today feels worse because on Monday, I was never really that green. Today, I was up 7,000 bucks and I, you know, pissed it away on some sloppy trades. And so I'm a little disappointed with that. But I'm also going to try to be really grateful for $350, which is enough to fill up the car with gasoline at $6.50 a gallon here on the island, and you know, maybe buy a sandwich as well. I don't know. I spent $50 on 2 sandwiches yesterday, so that money won't go too far here, but it's okay. So let's look at the trades from today. So first trade this morning. Actually, I don't even remember. I think. Yeah, first trades were actually on RDBX. But let's look at AREC first. So AERC, this had a really phenomenal move yesterday. And, you know, isn't it sort of just the luck of the draw that we end up having a, you know, 200% squeeze while I'm, you know, traveling and only trying to trade like 1-2 hours a day? So, of course, I missed it. I didn't trade it at all yesterday. Stock goes from 5 to 6 to 7 to 8 to 10 to 12 to 15, rejects hard off 1423. That marks what appears to be the top of the move, and then you get a little push higher. But this really, I think it was pretty obvious that this was not going to hold. Why? Because this was such a clear top, and this second attempt was on very light volume. So the volume profile was telling us this wasn't going to hold. It ended up rejecting, coming back down, and this morning tried to take a trade on it as it came back up right around 8 a.m. And I did get a couple nice trades. I got a nice trade on it right in here for the break of one right here, first pullback, second pullback. We had another trade right in here that led to a false breakout, and then got back in as it came up here for the breakthrough 12. But I sized up a little too heavy right here for the break of 12. It didn't break on the first try. It dipped down, and I averaged down on the position on this lower candle wick. My average was around, I don't know, 1185 or something. It comes up here to 92, and I was just like, okay, let's break 12. And it couldn't do it, and I stopped out. So that was the trade where I lost 2,000, went from up $7,000 on the day to up 5. And then this just sold off. It did break over VWAP and gave you this trade here from 11 to 13, but then it came all the way back down. So I don't know. I don't really feel like I missed that much on it. Today was backside of the move, and it wasn't easy. RDBX was the next one. This one actually was moving after hours yesterday, and then into after hours up to a high around 950, 945. This morning it squeezes up. And I traded this one pretty early as well. We had a nice pullback right here. false breakout right there, but then it came back up, broke through that level, and we got the squeeze here up to about 1120. On this one, I was up like 1500 on it or so, and then I jumped in here for this break of 11, and I sized up a little too heavy, 1125, 1130, adding at the high. And, you know, this is sort of like typical that, you know, at that point I was had just taken the $2,000 loss. Then this starts ripping and I jumped in it and I sized up for the breakout. And I was expecting that extension through 1125, 1135, 45, 50, maybe up to 12. The daily chart was great. No resistance. And then it just sort of pulled back. It faded. And I ended up losing, you know, 2,000 on that as it dropped back down. You could see that rejection. It was pretty nasty. So it rejects back down and then that was that. And then my last trade was on MICS, which I got in at like 4:30. Holy moly. Well, glad I missed that. Popped up here and then look at that flush. What garbage. So that was ugly. And then I made $700 on EFOI. That was a little earlier. So you know what? I just want to give myself a pat on the back for being green and try to stay green. That's the name of the game. Don't overstay your welcome. Get green, stay green, live to trade another day. Some days are going to be easier than others. Now, as always, my results are not typical and trading is risky and there's no guarantee you'll find success whether you learn from me or you trade on your own. But one of the things that I struggle with are on days like today where I start giving back profit. Right now, I could easily, let's just look, for example, SYM. SYM, I saw this halt up and this is when I shut it down. I was like, you know what? I'm going to jump in this thing. I'm going to, you know, hammer the ask on it and then it's going to flush into a halt down and I'm going to just like that go down $5,000-$6,000. And I'm going to say, man, you were up 7,000 today. You didn't stop when you were up five. You didn't stop when you were up two. You didn't stop when you were up 1500. You didn't stop when you were basically flat after commissions. Now you're red. When do you walk away? What kind of idiot are you? Why are you still trading? If it was a hot day, you would be at 5-10,000 right now. It's 11:15. Stop trading. Walk away. Come back tomorrow. Now sometimes you have to give yourself a little of that tough love, just to, you know, give yourself a little kick of what the heck are you thinking? You're being stupid. Be grateful. Be grateful for the opportunity to trade every single day. Trading is risky. Most people don't make it. If you walked away with $350, I can guarantee you that's more than a lot of people made working all day today, right? Working the night shift or working all morning up until now, doing a very hard job, something a lot harder than sitting on the couch here. So I want to try to remind myself of that. And, you know, it's human nature when you feel a sense of loss to try to get back what you've lost. And that's what requires a very high level of discipline to fight that urge. It's really important. So you know, I didn't chase this. It looks like it went into a second halt, but on extremely light volume, then it opened, it dropped 2 points, popped up, continued higher, then dropped down. You know, I just don't really regret. Looks like it halted again, which is kind of a weird halt. It's a very strange halt, but it halted again there, and then, anyway, so whatever. I didn't trade that. And then look at this IMTE. Look at this garbage. Holy moly. Down 54% today. What in the world? Now this stock. What's going on with this stock? You know, it goes to $40 and then it just gets hammered all the way back down on heavy volume. Heavy volume all the way back down. It grinds back up on light volume relatively and then it gets hammered right back down. There's some weird stuff going on in this one. I don't know what it is, but I'm not going to try to buy that dip. This thing could keep going. There's just something really, really weird going on with some of these stocks. And, you know, you have to remember that we are just, as retail traders, we are just a drop in the ocean. I mean, we are nothing. What you really, when you see moves like this, you've got to wonder, you know, who are the big money people that are in this stock? right, that actually own millions of shares? Are they selling? Why are the market makers not holding this up, right? Why are the market makers not providing liquidity on this? So there's stuff that goes on behind the scenes that, you know, we're left scratching our heads. But I'm not going to get in the way of that. I want to trade with the trend. I want to trade with whatever direction that big money is going. I'm not going to try to guess where they're going to stop selling, because this thing is selling hard today. So yeah, that one's pretty bad. But you know, something I was noticing today on AERC, this kept happening. I'd press the buy button. I'd see, you know, 10.50 on the ask. I'd get filled, 10.59. 9 cents of slippage. Now, I use offsets on my orders, so, you know, I give myself that offset, but usually I fill pretty much what I'm looking at. My internet has been good this whole time here, but we, you know, there is a storm today, and I mean, I don't know. I can't imagine that my ping is any different today than it was the other day. You just check it, but I can't imagine that's what it is. Just felt like something weird was going on AERC with the way the orders were routing and the way the market makers were matching those orders. So I don't really know. I'm not sure. But and then, you know, I just what's going on here? I really don't even. I'm not sure. I'm not sure what the deal is. Let's see. I'm going to change servers to. We'll just do New York City. That's fine. New York. So, yeah, I mean, my ping is 19 MS. So, milliseconds. That's a fine ping. Sometimes, you know, you'll end up getting these you get lagged out, but that's not what's going on. Anyway, so I don't really know, just some weird routing issues. I'll keep an eye on that as we go through the rest of the week. But so this week so far, you know, kind of a wash. Was basically, you know, flat on Monday, $150, basically flat today with $350. Yesterday, I think I was at 4,200 before fees and commissions, but knew I was probably at like $3,000 after. Kind of slower, but you know what? I set the goal of $1,000 a day. So 3 days in, thanks to yesterday, I've got the goal. You know, $1,000 a day average. So that's enough for me to feel like I've achieved my goal. It's better than being red, of course. And, you know, I'll come back at it Thursday, Friday. See if we can finish the week with a couple more nice opportunities. I think one of the problems today was that we had attention dispersed quite a bit. You had RDBX, you had IMTE a little bit maybe. I don't know. You had certainly AERC, MICS. You know, there's just a lot of stocks moving. And when you get that dispersed attention, you don't usually get really good follow through on any single stock. So the writing was on the wall pretty early as those started fading at the end of pre-market that this probably wasn't going to be a super hot day. So shutting it down here, live to trade another day, and reminder as always that trading is risky. My results are not typical, so I encourage you to take it slow. Now, if you want to watch the video, I'll put the link right up here for the technical analysis multi-part series. I'll put video one right up here that you guys should check out. It's a 10-part multi-series, tons of videos there, 10 videos. I think you guys will enjoy it. So check those out. I hope you go through them and hit the thumbs up. It always helps feed that YouTube algo. So thank you guys for doing that. And I'll see you back here first thing tomorrow morning for the morning show. All right. See you in the morning.